hands. Because she is a strong, principled conservative. She is an American grizzly. Now, the gentleman over here asked about teleprompters. We all remember when she addressed the nation at the convention, electrified the nation. What not everybody knows is the teleprompter broke in the middle of her speech. And yet she looked at this country and said, we got to stand for the principles this country was based on. She said, we got to stand for limited government. We got to stand for liberty. We got to stand for the Constitution. Has anyone ever seen a mama grizzly scared of anything? No. I am incredibly proud and humbled to have the support of a fearless, principled conservative who is speaking the truth to power. Can we turn around our country? Yeah. You betcha. Yeah. Governor Sarah Palin. Yeah.
Teaches you good competition and teaches you how to be self-disciplined and take personal responsibility, all those things that bode well for most Americans today who want to see America get back on the right track by exercising that personal responsibility and that initiative, that American drive that allowed America to become the most prosperous and voluntarily generous and secure and greatest, most exceptional nation on earth. All those good things, I learned a lot about it from Texans. I have good family who lives in Texas too, the Sheeran clan, and good friends who, they travel back and forth between Alaska and Texas. In fact, a lot of us do. We come to Texas to vacation, and one of my friends asking, you're going back to Texas? You know, do you really love it that much? And I said, yeah, and I even kind of get used to the claustrophobia of Texas. You guys have some good places here that are fun and successful, and one of those places, Jason, you're going to have to take me on our way back to the airport later. We drive by a Chick-fil-A. We don't. Nobody's a Chick-fil-A, so we'll go there, Jason, on the way, okay? No, I really do sincerely love Texas. Texas is a place, too, where there's just something about this place where you guys seem to welcome all, and you don't have to feel obligated, I think, as a visitor to shake off that where you come from dust from your boots. You fit. Speaking of boots, I had to wear the boots. You know who gave me these boots? Your governor. Case you made a good decision, maybe not in this case, but now, you know, we'll be a team after this is all over again, okay? No, aside from the weather, our states do share a lot in common. We have these wide open spaces. We have these big, beautiful blue skies. We have the energy, both of our states do, the energy that's helping to fuel this economy, the natural resources that God created for man's responsible use, that which we should be tapping into to a greater degree. We share those. I think most importantly, though, we share the fierce, patriotic, very, very independent, proud, proud Americana spirit our two states do. And again, that's what makes me so proud to be a part of this team, a part of this event, helping to build up even more support to send a great American to Washington, D.C. to work for all of us in Texas. We do have a lot in common. In fact, looking around, I recognize some of y'all, or you guys, as we would say. I recognize some bitter clingers out there, right? No, we're not bitter when we cling to our God, our guns, and our Constitution. It's not being bitter. It's because there's nothing better when it comes to the reflection, the illustration of those things that are good and needed and contributing factors to this most exceptional nation. Those who bitterly, if you will, cling to God, guns, Constitution. Those, you know, a lot of you clingers, you seem to understand too that freedom is a God-given right and freedom is worth fighting for. And if you love your freedom, you thank a vet. So we do want to take a minute to thank America's finest, our United States military men and women. I heard President Obama recently zip through your state, and I heard that he said something about Texas, kind of took me aback. He said that he believes it's becoming a battleground state real soon. The press wrote, and I quote, President Obama revved up Democrats in the traditionally red state by telling them he sees shades of purple in Texas that might ultimately turn blue down the line. Like, huh? The only time he'll see purple and blue in Texas is if he's watching TCU versus SMU. Nah, there will be an Alaskan-sized blizzard on the Brazos before Texas turns blue for Barack. Four years ago, candidate Obama promised to fundamentally transform America, and for all the left's failures, for all the broken promises, that is one promise that President Obama has kept. His hope-be-changey agenda is transforming America from a nation of hope to one of uncertainty and anxiety. But thank God, the far left's radical, irresponsible policies and their lapdogs in the media practicing yellow journalism, what they did was to awaken a sleeping giant in America. Awaken America so that folks could understand what it was that we were about to lose. And what we were about to lose would be those blessings of prosperity, those blessings of liberty. And the working man then, the working man and woman, we decided to rise up. We the people, we rose up. We showed up in the town halls. We ended up in the ballot box. And that 2010 electoral victory, thanks to the Tea Party patriots, who put up with so much coming from the media and from the left, the false accusations, we the people, we rose up, voted in a new team of leaders, and we said, no, we're rejecting their big government agenda because we don't want it, we don't need it, we can't afford it, and we're unwilling to pay for it. In 2010, we sent a new team of leaders to Washington. But what happened next, though? Sent the guys and the gals to Washington. And in some cases, it became quite apparent that there is some success in the permanent political class kind of trying to co-opt them, trying to make them just a part of the status quo, to get in line, fall in line, go with the flow. We're we're commercial fishermen, Todd and I. Todd just got off the Bristol Bay Fishing Grounds, and Todd says he reminds me all the time, as he's watching the schools of fish and coming in and out, he said, only dead fish go with the flow. We saw how the permanent political class in D.C. tried to co-opt this new class of leaders in Washington and suck them into the status quo. I swear, status quo must be Latin for the mess we're in. See, the reality is we are governed by a permanent political class, and we're in a battle to change that. We must change that for America's solvency and for our sovereignty. We must change that. And 2010 was just a step in that long march towards the real reform that we need. Texas, will you keep fighting? Will you keep marching for that real reform that we need in Washington? The permanent political class won't go quietly, though. Politicians from both sides of the aisle, they've failed us because they've spent us into this mind-boggling debt, and they've abandoned the Constitution too often. And sure, they take that oath, right, to defend the Constitution, and yet then they ignore it when it gets in the way of just doing that business as usual in Washington. For instance, like when the left crams down that mother of all unfunded mandates, that death panel filled Orwellian nonsense called Obamacare, when they rammed that down our throat and ignore the Constitution. Or when they skirt their constitutional responsibility to even pass a budget. We're going on 4 years now without a federal budget, and they think they get to just ignore the Constitution in that case. Politicians, too, you know, they talk about cutting spending, yet they keep spending more. They talk about our massive, unsustainable debt, yet they keep incurring more. They spend, they print, they borrow, they spend more, and then they stick us with the bill. But in this come to Jesus moment that we're having, this come to Jesus discussion, there's good news. There is good news, and that is there is nothing wrong with America that a good old-fashioned fair election can't fix. To fix it, to restore American exceptionalism, to restore America's promise, we must elect leaders with courage, selfless, those with servants' hearts, willing to take a stand and fight against the big government cheerleaders. And that's why Todd and I are here today in Texas, proudly standing with Ted Cruz. Ted is a proven common sense constitutional conservative, and he's a fighter, and he will bring new leadership to the United States Senate. He will shrink government. He will be putting it back on the side of the people, and he will defend the United States Constitution. Friends, the only real solution to big government waste and fraud, to this debt, it's sudden and it's relentless reform. And Ted will fight for that. But he needs your help. He needs your support. He needs your vote. And remember that real reform never sits well with the entrenched special interests. And that's why the voices of true reform are so easily and quickly demonized. And they're mocked. And they're lied about. Those who represent the status quo will stop at nothing to block positive change, and Ted Cruz represents the positive change that we need. Folks, he represents that change, and that is why you see the disgusting attacks thrown at him. He, though, like a true Texan, he's still standing tall. He's still here with his head up, with his shoulders back, ready to take on those who do not want to see that positive change. And we know that Ted will take the same courage, the same determination to walk. Washington to work for all Americans. He'll be a leading voice for common sense conservatives when we take back the United States Senate. It's not just to change the majority and control of the Senate. It's to make sure that principled conservatives like Ted are there to fight for us, to fight for the working man. Ted is not going to D.C. to make nice with the foo-foo, she-she cocktail crowd. Not at all. He's going, as government is driving us over a cliff, no, he's going to do the heavy lifting to rein in our out-of-control government, and to repeal Obamacare, and to fight Obama's tax hikes. He's going to be there to stop the DPA from absolutely crushing our small businesses with the overregulation that they are thriving on. He's going to passionately defend our Second Amendment rights. He's going there to protect all of our constitutionally protected rights. He's going there to defend our free market system. And you know, those examples that I just gave, realize that those are symptoms of a failed ideology of the far left as led by President Obama. There's a good Senate candidate in Maryland, Dan Bongino. And he recently gave a speech about that. These are just symptoms of a failed ideology and how important it is to recognize that those who are in the majority right now in the Senate and President Obama, they actually believe that government can spend your money better than you can. They believe that they are smarter than you are, and yet these experts are the ones who get us into the mess in the first place. These experts are the ones that have allowed the $16 trillion debt. The fact that the situation that we're in, where one in five working age men in America can't find work, where one in seven American families are on food stamps, where 30% of our mortgages are underwater. We do have a housing market that's in the tank, where we're ticking off allies left and right around the globe, where we're subsidizing developments, including energy development in foreign countries, instead of drilling here, drilling now in Texas for the energy that our country needs. Oh, but they're the smart ones. Now, for the last 4 years, we have seen how Barack Obama's fundamental transformation of America can bring our great nation to her knees. I say it's time that we stand up again, that we take a stand so that we can stand tall, stand proud like a Texan does, and make America exceptional again. We don't need a fundamental transformation. We need a fundamental restoration of all that is good and free and safe and secure in America. Fighters like Ted Cruz can lead the charge for us. So, Texas, will you send a good man to Washington, D.C. to fight for all of us? Can we count on you to support Ted and vote for Ted? Texas, can America count on you to keep Texas red? Then let's get it done. And I thank you. God bless Texas and God bless the United States of America. Thank you, Texas.
Nobody swell me. people from Texas. I've never gone to Tennessee.